Well, so as we have done till exercise E of chapter 3, that is synthetic fibers and plastic. Okay, so in continuation of that, today we will do exercise F, that is long answer type question. Oh, so student, in these questions, you have to write the answer of this question in a long. Okay, you have to explain each and everything. So the question one is define monomer, polymer, polymerization. Then how are these terms related to each other? Explain with examples. Okay, student. So in this question, you have to write the definition of monomer, polymer, and polymerization. So as we all know that monomer are the smaller units of polymer, and when these monomer combined, they form the long chain and that represent the polymer. And the process by which the monomer combine to form the polymer is known as polymerization. Okay, so as we all know that if we talk about a polymer, polythene, so in this poly means many and ethene are the monomer unit. So a large number of ethene units combine to form a polymer, polythene, and its process is known as polymerization. Okay, similarly, if we talk about the polyester, in which poly stand for many and ester stand for monomer units. Okay, so in this, what happened at the time of process of polymerization, the ester units combine to form the polyester, and this process is known as polymerization. So let's see the answer of this question number one. First one is monomer. Monomer, each of the smaller units in a polymer is known as monomer. Okay. Next one is the polymer. Synthetic fibers and plastics are made of long chains of repeating monomers that forms a polymer. And the polymer is derived from Greek word poly means many and mer meaning unit or part. Okay. Next one is the polymerization. The process through which the monomers combine to form a polymer is called polymerization. And if we talk about the example, ethene is the monomer of polyethene or polyethene or polythene, then ethene is represented by the formula CH2, double bond is there, CH2. Therefore, the structure of polythene can be written as, if we can write like this, then in or a long chain will be formed, or just if we want to represent the for in a form of formula, so that will be represented CH2, CH2, and it will be closed in a bracket NN. N represent the number of units, number of monomer units combined to form the polymer. The monomers combined by the process of polymerization to form the polymers. Next, student, question two is, how is rayon manufactured? In this question, student, you have to write how we can prepare a synthetic fiber rayon. Okay, so as we all know that rayon is known as artificial silk and it is obtained from the wood pulp. Okay, and so let's see the answer of this question number two. Rayon is prepared from cellulose obtained from wood pulp. The cellulose that is obtained from the wood pulp, it is known as regenerated fiber. Since cellulose is broken down and then formed again, cellulose first obtained from the wood pulp, then it is broken down and again it is formed. That's why it is known as regenerated fiber. How it is prepared? Wood pulp is first treated with sodium hydroxide, that is a chemical, and then carbon disulfide to obtain a thick liquid called viscous, and this viscous solution is forced through tiny holes into a metal cylinder kept inside dilute sulfuric acid bath. In this way, lustrous and continuous fibers of rayon are produced. Okay, students, next question three is, write in brief the characteristics of synthetic fibers. So student, in this question, you have to write the characteristics or the properties of synthetic fibers. So we have already discussed that the synthetic fibers are strong, light, durable, easy to wash. They do not absorb water. They are moth proof. Okay. And they are wrinkle resistant. They do not shrink. okay, and so if they do not shrink, it means there is no need to iron these. These are the properties. And if we talk about the disadvantages of these fiber, they do not absorb the sweat and don't allow it to evaporate. So that will be the uncomfortable condition. And they catches fire easily and they are non-biodegradable too. So they will lead to soil pollution. So let's see the answer of this question number 3. Synthetic fibers are strong, light, durable, easy to wash and moth proof. They do not shrink or wrinkle and therefore need little or no ironing. Since they do not absorb water or moisture, they dry quickly. This property becomes a disadvantage with the fabric made of this fiber as they do not absorb sweat or allow it to evaporate. Next is the fabric stick to the body and make the wearer uncomfortable during summer months. Next is synthetic fiber catches fire easily. They burn, shrink and melt forming beads which stick to the skin. Therefore, they should not be worn in the kitchen or while working near fire. The next is that fibers are non-biodegradable and cause soil pollution. The fabrics made of synthetic fibers develop a charge known as static electricity in the dry weather. Sparks due to the charge developed can be seen in the dark. And this causes skin problem in many people. Okay, so student, after this, the question number 4 is, write short note on thermoplastic and thermosetting plastics. Okay, student, so as we have already discussed that thermoplastics are the plastic, they are formed by linear linking of the monomer units. Then if we talk about the thermosetting plastic, they are formed by cross linking of the monomer units. Thermoplastic becomes soft and they melt on heating, whereas thermosetting plastic become hard and they do not become soft, and the linking present in them become more cross-linked. As a result of this, what happened? The thermoplastic can be molded again and again into different shapes, whereas the thermosetting plastics are hard and they break if we apply pressure on it, and they cannot be remolded again and again to different shapes. If we talk about the examples of thermoplastics are PVC, polythene, polystyrene, polyester, okay, nylon. Next, if we talk about the thermosetting plastic, examples are bakelite, melamine, all are the examples of thermosetting plastics. So student, let's see the answer of this question number 4. Answer of this question number 4 is, the first one is thermoplastics. These can be softened on heating and molded repeatedly into desired shapes. Examples are polythene, PVC, polypropylene, polystyrene, polyester, perspex and nylon are some common thermoplastic. They bend easily on applying pressure and get deformed on heating. Next, the second one is the thermosetting plastics. These can be molded into a shape only once. Only one time we can give them a shape and cannot be softened or melted on heating. If we reheat them, they do not become soft and they do not melt. This is because the chains get highly cross-linked on heating. Examples are bakelite and melamine are some examples of them. So student, these are the pictures of the material which are made from the thermoplastic. Okay, plastic bottles are there, ice cube trays are there, here you can see, okay. Next, these are the articles which are made from the thermosetting plastic, and you can see these plastics are mostly, these articles are mostly hard and stiff, and they break if we apply more pressure on them. Okay, student, next is, question number 5 is, what is the proper method of disposal of plastic? So student, in this question, you have to write the ways that we should use to proper disposal of plastic. So first of all, as we all know that plastics, if we talk about the plastic, they all are, plastics are also polymers. They are also like synthetic fibers and they are non-biodegradable, means they cannot be decomposed by the living organism into the simpler form. So, but it leads to pollution. Okay, it leads to death of the cattle that feed on them. Next is, if we burn the plastic, so that releases a lot of poisonous gases into the atmosphere and that leads to environment pollution. So after this we have to follow some ways to for the proper disposal of plastic. So first one is that we should separate the biodegradable and non-biodegradable substance. Second thing is, and disposing plastic in proper places and not in the sewage system, because that will leads to blocking of the sewage system. And next is reuse it, recycle it or reduce it. And the last method is incineration, means burning of plastic. As a result of this, what will happen, the volume of the plastic waste can be reduced, okay, and the energy, heat energy is produced, and that is also of very much use. So let's see the answer of this question number 5. Answer 5 is, plastic take many more years to decompose completely, so several methods have been suggested to reduce the pollution caused by it, and the following steps should be taken for its disposal and conservation of the environment. So first one is, we have to segregate biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste and disposing them accordingly. Accordingly, we have to dispose the biodegradable and the non-biodegradable waste. The second one is disposing plastic in proper places and not in the sewage system, on roads, streets or on barren lands. The third one is recycling or reusing plastic. If it is possible, so we have to recycle it and we have to reuse it. The plastic is collected, sorted, melted and remolded. The fourth one, the last, is incineration or burning of plastic at very high temperature reduces the volume of waste, provides useful supply of heat energy and also breaks the polluting gases produced during the reaction. So student, these are the answers of your exercise F. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.